Let's go. Proving everything to lose. Gunshine State Podcast in this motherfucker. Well, so you know what I'm doing. Shoot. Ain't no flaw shit in my timepiece. Ain't no love handles on my side piece. No. She don't call me baby. Careful what you ask for. 3, 2, 1, who's party almost out of time last month. Up the boulevard with Crenshaw High Monica. You see your waving, it ain't for no high Monica. Flossy, I see carrots in the face. Who is you, Frosty? Not Dirty Harry, make my day. Answer one question. Do you peep the way I'm moving? No, you keep your eye out for the ballers, but please don't be stupid.
Black Jack.
Hey, and we back with another episode from the Gunshine State Podcast. I'm your boy 305. This the Gunshine State Podcast where we take shots and shoot the shits, and we stand the ground on the shit that we shoot, nigga.
Oh, man, yeah. It's your boy, Black, man. Y'all already know we turn up every time when we in the motherfucking building.
That's your boy, Easy. Apply pressure all day, you hear me?
See, we ain't did this in a long time. You know you gotta let that drop, y'all. let go. Now you go.
That's Easy with apply pressure. What they do? We back, man. New year. New dollar.
Yeah, we in the
We got biz in this bitch.
And we do have a special guest in the motherfucking building. I got the homie Biz Levin in the motherfucking building, man. Gunshots to you, man.
Building. Welcome to the building.
Man, we appreciate you coming through, homie.
Oh, no problem. Shut up. Never mind. All right, no.
Come on.
You know how we give it up.
We finna give it up. So if y'all don't know, but if y'all are listeners of the Gunshine State Podcast, y'all know that we book Biz at least 10 times.
Yeah. At least
10 times. Nigga, when we first started, nigga, I wanted Biz to be the first guest because he had just had them drop Sorbet around about the time. And damn. I was bumping that shit all the way in motherfucking South Carolina, nigga. It was North Carolina that year. That shit was fire, but and Biz is he's a hell of a man to get up with.
Hey, businessman, you know, gotta catch up with him, bro.
No, don't.
That's how I be, man.
Don't applaud that shit, bro.
Because
you're a hard man to get up with too.
Yeah, see, that's why he doing it.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh man. So we definitely booked Biz 10 times, and then it was even one time my nigga when I caught the nigga at the battle. I'm like, bro, what's up? This is probably after like 5.
Okay.
I was like, yo, bro, what happened? He's like, man, I'm going to be there tomorrow, bro. Tomorrow, bro. Don't even worry about it. I'm going to be there tomorrow, bro. I said, all right, nah.
Hey, it's business.
Like, one of them times, this nigga hit me up and was like, that might have been that one. He was like, I said I'd be there tomorrow, and that night, nigga hit me up and was like, all right, so you flying to California, you got the studio, and this, and this afterwards. And I was like,
yeah, this nigga here.
So this nigga hopped on my live while I'm in California, and he was like, so I guess you're not going to make it.
On the live.
This nigga Biz, man.
I guess you're not going to make it.
This nigga Biz be moving, man. So on that note, man, let's go ahead and take shots, man. Let's get right. Okay, boom. And then I want to do a game. Oh, something new. Ready? First of the year. Pick a number. You can pick a number from 1 to 10 or 1 to 20. It's going to determine what's going to happen.
I'm picking 11.
11. Every 11 minutes, we take a shot.
Yeah, red in that bitch too.
Let's go. Yeah, every 11 minutes we shut.
Oh,
we shoot.
Time.
Jesus. Hey, what Siri. Set my timer for 11 minutes.
Okay.
All right, so we're finna go ahead and take this shot. Let's go. Hey, God, I appreciate y'all. Happy New Year, man.
Happy New Year
to you too. Hey, Easy, what you doing over there, man? Cheating, bro.
Hey,
where you shot at, bro? Easy cheating, bro.
I almost made it this time. See, I got all last year. They ain't even know. Nah. I put a little water in the cup.
Nah.
There you go. What you drinking? Tequila, you drinking?
Bro, we got tequila. That's all we got. You can get this 1800 here.
It's a little something there.
You can get the crystal.
Oh, you want some grandma? Yeah, it all depends on you.
Give me that trunk.
What that is?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the rock. That's the rock right there.
Oh, that's the rock.
If you smell,
you think everybody like, yeah, all right, nigga. Hope you got a ride, nigga.
Nah, that shit just super smooth, dog.
Yeah,
if
shit,
you smell.
Oh, man. My homegirl was drinking that the other night. And it's...
Yeah, my brother bought me that for my birthday. I mean, not for my birthday, for Christmas. I appreciate him.
No problem.
Hey, man. All right. Another trip around the sun. Hey, and I'm really pissed off because in Monopoly, you get $200 every time you pass go. They ain't right. Give me shit. Nah, Mm. Oh yeah.
That's how you start off shit.
Mm. Alright, so full disclosure, that's number three for me right now. So
and then you
as
still
the
night,
as the time progresses every 11 minutes. Lord.
You still got 9 minutes to go, so so let's get into it, man.
Water on his bed.
So usually we recap the week, you know what I'm saying? But we've been off since Thanksgiving, you know what I'm saying? Go
to my favorite part of the show.
Listen, so we've been off since Thanksgiving. Everybody had a good time, you know what I'm saying, vacation or whatnot. So instead of just the week, I just say we just go ahead and delve into that whole little vacation that we had. You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead, go first. Easy, since it's your first.
Because you know this easy favorite part of the show.
Man, see, this is shit. We're going to talk later, Biz. We're going to talk about them more niggas on air. Yo, the holidays was good, though. It was a little different for me this year because last year I lost my dad, and the year before that I lost Tess. You know what I'm saying? And one was before Christmas, and one was the day of Christmas. So this year was like, you know, I was like, you know what? I ain't going to go that route. You know, mm-hmm. I'm not going to go that route of just moping and doing all that, you know. So I went to hanging with the kids and shit, you know what I'm saying? They opening their gifts and shit. And I had to sit down and think for a minute. I'm like, yo, you been to prison before. You know what I'm saying? You been to prison before, and it's fellas out that road that, like, they ain't getting this. They ain't getting to talk with their kids. They not getting to, you know, eat what they want to eat. They ain't getting to shoot the shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Call it. You know what I'm saying? Best they can do is send a letter home or call home. And I'm like, damn, nigga, you was in that situation. But this where you at now. You like, you got a clothing line going. You got shit going. You got a business going, multiple businesses. And shit moving and going in the right direction. So it's like, that was a gift alone. You know what I'm saying? I didn't even want nothing else. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So anything else that came along with it, it just came, you know? But Thanksgiving, it was good just to be around family and people that, you know, that you can depend on, you can rely on, you know what I'm saying? So other than that shit, I had a good vacation. Black, how your shit was?
Man, shit. It wasn't too much crazy, but Thanksgiving, I ain't do too much. I ended up having to work a little bit longer. So when I got home that morning, I actually just passed out that whole Thanksgiving. Yeah. That Thanksgiving night, man, I ain't do anything too much. I took in some more hours at the job, got in with that. Over the weekend from Christmas, my mom got a little sick down there. Went down there, got her back together. You know, she doing good now, whatever like that. Spent time with my daughter. We kicked it. We went to Orlando for a little bit. Came back in. New Year's, I was at the crib chilling, meditating, manifesting, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So that's what basically my whole holiday, my little break went. That's how that went.
Biz. So yeah, how was your holidays, homie?
It was cool, man. I was doing the same thing. Thanksgiving, I think it was real low key. I ain't do nothing. Like, I just like chill. I think I took like the highlight might have been a good shower for real. I sat around and wrote for a little bit. Ate, and that was it. Then Christmas, that was low-key too. Got to see my kids do they thing, you know what I'm saying?
Because that's what it really stuff. Be about.
Really?
And kids, that will make the holidays even exciting. You know, as you get older, it's not really, you know, you're ready to work, you're ready to get some day, paper, you feel me?
That's pretty much what it was. It was like, they gave us like the day off for Christmas, of course, but I mean, besides that, and then, I don't know, there was like a new, either it was like a new flu going around. So like I was
the Omarion. Okay, no, not the Omarion.
Nah, but shit, it was another little illness going around besides COVID. And so, you know, people at my job was dropping like flies and shit, like, you know what I'm saying?
Damn,
you know,
man.
Yeah, I went
either
back.
You got to be on point with your vitamins and shit. Like, they got to take care of yourself, man. What? You definitely, because they trying to hit us on every corner.
Everyone.
So, every corner, man. So you definitely got to be on top of y'all shit, man. Don't, you know, these days, you know, a lot of our black folks.
C-Mosh, like, elderberry, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Shit. Get that shit in you.
And it definitely works.
Sunlight, you know.
Yeah, because, you know, us guys, sometimes we'll be like, oh, we ain't taking no medicine. Or we gonna let it work for ourselves, you know. But these days, you can't be like that.
You can't be like that. Cause these shits are getting stronger,
vitamins, boy.
You know what I'm saying? Fi, how your week?
Oh man, vacation.
How your vacation was. I'm talking about
vacation week. Was good, man. It was. I missed y'all. I miss doing this shit, man. Like, just
that was a long ass break, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
I don't.
It seemed like it was fast.
Kind of long.
I guess because I'm constantly working.
Wasn't,
constantly
it wasn't a real break because y'all was at the battle.
I was at the battle.
I came late. I was dead late.
And only reason I was at the battle because I missed doing this shit, bro. I was.
That boy ran down on me. He was like, no. Sit down. Yeah.
I missed doing this shit so much, though. So I wanted to get to work. You know what I'm saying? So. But yeah, just coming here every week talking to y'all, man. Shit, but we was working behind the scenes, new logos. Cameraman, you know what I'm saying? We getting shit together, you know what I'm saying?
Shaking shit. Shout out to
Cameraman. Yeah, man. We got some big interviews lined up. I don't want to speak on air just yet about it. Yeah. I like to keep my head down and work before we can even
let your work speak
put out
yourself.
There, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But y'all know what's going on. Shit, work. I'm sick of fucking work so bad, bro. Like it's crazy. Dog, I want to fucking blast my supervisor right now. I don't even give a fuck if he listen to this shit, bro. Like,
don't fuck with the bread and butter right now.
Fuck that, bro. I'm bread and butter, nigga.
Yeah, but you got to go there.
No, I don't.
You don't have to go there, but you go there.
They need me, bro. I'm him.
I hear you, bro. I'm not trying to go back.
Talk your shit, Fi.
Like, that shit, dog. Nigga, get on my nerves, dog. Fuck it, we gonna get into it. Bitch ass nigga. we gonna get into it. So the nigga had that. So the nigga had that. So it was two people in my department. One of the niggas, he went out on vacation during December, for his wedding or whatnot. Mm-hmm. So he got married. So now that left me over there in the department by myself. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Now first off, I'm 4 or 5 months in there, y'all know, but I'm him. I don't give a fuck. I'm finna be over here running this bit. You know what I'm saying? So, now mind you, before this, we had inventory. Inventory was voluntary. We had to count everything in the warehouse. It's voluntary, bro. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, nigga, we got shit to do. I got shit to do. I got the motherfucking car wash on Saturdays. Sundays we podcast. You know what I'm saying? I'm not finna do that. I'm not. I'm gonna be in here an hour after. I stayed there at 6. I used to get off at 5. I stayed there at 6 on Friday. I ain't come in no more for the rest of the weekend. I'm not mandatory to be in there. Mm-hmm. I got my own money to get. You know what I'm saying?
You did what you got to do already. Got in and got out.
I did. Yeah, and yeah. I did a little more. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So come that Monday when I was there by myself, I'm over there by myself. This nigga, he already know that one of the niggas had to. He's off for the week. I had no help. My supervisor, like, cause usually it's two people over there. So when they get backed up, he come out, he help out. You know what I'm saying? But the nigga ain't do none of that shit. So nah, I'm over there like, but fuck it, I'm running that bitch. You feel what I'm saying? So people come to me, yo, can you do this? Can you do this? And he be done walked over there. They be like, man, I know you only one man. I know you doing it. He look. Keep walking, you know what I'm saying? So now the nigga had done came back. I done been there all week. Thursday, the new dude who had done went on vacation, he came back. Yep. Thursday, boom. Okay. So Friday when we got back, I come in there my regular time because I was going in at 5. I come in there my regular time at around like 8. I see the nigga out helping the nigga now. I'm like, wow, yo, what the fuck?
Listen, you already said what it was. You said. You him.
They see that.
They see that.
That other so they leaving that shit.
Sometimes you can't show a job that shit.
The other nigga that took the week off,
he not him.
He not him.
So they gonna give you to you all that pressure like that.
The only reward for hard work is more work.
Shit, that's real shit.
That's real shit.
Talk that shit. But that's how they see that you do that shit real easy and cool and collect. Oh, they give it to you because they know you can handle it real quick. They throw it to you.
Yeah.
So. That's the timer. That's the timer. Shots. Shots. I like this game.
This is a fucking word.
Watch.
I like this game.
Hey, watch what happened. I'm in this.
You can do a poquito.
You can do a poquito. Nah, man, I can't. If I end this live, I'm gonna just be like, all right, yo, and the next thing you know, they gonna wake up in the morning. I'm still in the driveway.
Sleep. So the couch. We got a couple of victims on the couch.
Oh no. Nah.
Came to the couch.
Yeah. Hey, shouts out to McFly. McFly was here. We had McFly. Him on. Yeah, my homie. He cut the hair.
Oh no, nah, I was thinking about somebody else. Oh, I was about to say. Yeah. Hey, listen. Oh nah. Matter of fact, now y'all, let's go ahead and let's. Since you had beef with the niggas with y'all, let's go ahead.
Let's take these shots.
Let's go ahead and talk about this little.
Hey Siri, this little spinach juice. Set my timer for 11 minutes.
Gee.
All right. So let me finish off because I got you.
Mm-hmm.
So the nigga was out there helping the nigga, and I'm like, oh, what the fuck? So now, mind you, I was over there all week by myself. So shit, I got backed up, stupid. You know what I'm saying? And so now I'm looking like the blame. So nigga say, I don't need you over here no more, man. You go to the warehouse side. And I'm over in the warehouse side chilling my ass off, like, because it ain't shit to do over there. And the nigga we put over there, he don't even want to be over there no more. You know what I'm saying? So I'm dealing with that and, like, really frustrated with that shit. And then I got...
still winning in the way, because at times you be free, and then at times you put the work in because, like you said, you him. So you got to do that. It comes with it.
Heavy is the head, the golden custom Kringle.
That man, yeah.
So what'd you say, Biz? Go ahead.
Nah, I was gonna ask you. You said you had some news for me.
Oh no, I got the okay. You know, so what we gonna do is we'll go ahead and take a break. Q, we gonna go take a break right now. You can if you need to. I don't know how to do it. We'll go ahead and take a break, and we'll be right back with the Gunshine State Podcast. I got some tea. I got some Earl Grey.
Some Earl.
Got that energy for y'all.
Dude. And we back with another episode from the Gunshine State Podcast. Nigga, happy new year. First episode of the year, man.
Bitches.
What's going on, man? Hey. Like I said, man, I missed y'all, man. So let's go ahead. Let's get into our guest today, man. We got the homie Biz Levin.
Pause. Biz.
Hey,
what's
that? Listen. It's Biz 1E1 now.
What? Oh, like, oh, see, that's another question.
Biz 1E1.
Biz 1N1?
1E1. No.
1E1.
You got 22, you got 33, you got 44, right. 55, 60. I'm 1E1.
You
1E1. You know what, Biz? I'ma run with it, dog. I'ma run with it. Fuck it.
I'ma
run with it because it's new. I'ma run with it. Fuck it. I ain't going against it.
You feel me?
So
I posted that today too.
1E1.
So let's get to the Earl Grey, right?
Yeah.
So I had a
yeah, you want me to get it?
No, I got you. I'm gonna keep it so he know, but he don't know. For everybody don't know. So I had somebody come here. There was somebody they got a band. Okay. They got a band. You know what I'm saying? They band is the name of this joint that I got in my hand.
I said this was gonna laugh.
I'm totally lost, but
I know you lost.
Don't worry, I'm feeling
right. You got it.
All right. Wait, hold on. It's two of them now. It's two bands like that now. So it's
the one that you worked with recently.
I don't work with both of them recently.
Okay. Well, then they was on. They was up there Monday. Now they not up there Monday.
All right. So yeah, go ahead.
So when they came here, they was like, man, I see y'all be up there on Mondays at the spot, man. Y'all be, and he was like, nah, we not. The one that played the keys.
I know. I already knew it was.
So he was like, "Nah, we not." And listen, I don't even feel messy because I told the nigga we was cool then at the podcast. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm gonna ask the nigga about this shit. So okay,
so tell me what he said happened.
And he was like, "Nah, he cool. He went in, but he ain't go in." You know what I'm saying? He alluded to like, when you get that liquor in you, man, you ain't that nigga no more. Listen. You turning to random.
The thing is, all right, so what happened was, because low-key these niggas quit for real. They quit. It wasn't like you fired. It was a you fired situation. But on my face, I was like, no, let these niggas live. Like, you know what I'm saying? We can grow with them. You know what I'm saying? So, all right. So, what happened is.
And shouts out to them because they are talented.
Shouts out to them. Like, I still, they fuck with me for real. Like, and if they don't, then, I mean, they put on a good face. And I No, for real. Dead serious. So, what happened was one night we at Onyx, smoking word happening this. It was a previous conversation between him and Jessica that I didn't know about, about they price. So.
Oh, they go to timer. Oh, shots. Man. Shots.
It's about to get real.
Wait, how long we on the air for? Like, wait a minute.
Listen.
Y'all like my new game?
Hell no, I don't like it.
I like this shit.
This shit all right.
I got shit to do when I leave here. I'm going to bed.
Hey, man. Welcome to the Gunshine State Podcast, man. That's how we doing it.
Every 21 minutes. I'm cutting my shit in half.
Every 21 minutes.
That's why you figure that.
Up here with 21.
21 minutes.
I knew he was going to pick 11, little kid.
Yeah, you did. That's why he said you can't go to 10. Yeah, that's why he said.
Yeah, because I wanted to stop at 10. Because I wanted to be shot. You know what I'm saying?
Nah. All right,
All right,
it's a previous conversation between him and Jess about his about their price.
Holy shit.
What happened to that water?
And so
yeah, nigga needs some water.
And so they brought their price up. I mean, which anybody gonna do if they can see something growing and they still feel like they're making the same amount of money, but more money is coming in.
Right.
I mean,
right.
Let's renegotiate. I get that. So this is where it get different. I don't think it's never been spoken out loud, but the general consensus was that the level of musical knowledge wasn't where we need to be paying for. Like, what the price was, and it's not the fact that they weren't talented, it was the fact that, okay, you niggas was born in 2000, but y'all haven't done the, backstory type work.
Because you can't be born in 2000 and still do your homework on the moon.
But this wasn't necessarily the case.
So with them, it was like, yeah, y'all talented. Y'all can flow with us. But it feels like we stuck in like a certain genre of music when we fuck with y'all. Yeah. Uh-huh. And so I think after that night, what happens? I think they get their money. And just say, this what they get. I don't give a fuck what they talking about. You know what I'm saying? This what they getting for what they doing. I was like, cool. What they didn't know was, oh, no, that's not what happened. They got what they asked for in the envelope. But something else happened prior in that night where either they was like late or something. Like they came late. They left early. Packed up in the middle of the show. And so I took it upon myself and I was like, okay, well, all right, I'm the one that kind of vouched for them because they were supposed to be fired the week before.
Mm. Wow.
I vouched for them, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to personally take out $100 from what they was finna get.
Everybody and shit like that. Because
I'm going to take $100 out of their shit, which now you just back down to what you was getting originally.
Exactly.
And I'm going to just give it to you. And then when you see it, we're going to have a conversation. We're going to talk about it.
And I'll tell you why it was this and what happened.
So When he said the alcohol thing was like, I was like, we was all outside. It's just them. It's the whole band and just me. So we talking and I'm telling them, you know, this and the third, like this what happened. And it kind of got like a little rowdy and I was like, I'm letting y'all niggas know, like, right now. I'm humbling myself, but you know what I'm saying? It's three or four of y'all right now. And the position that I'm in as a man, it ain't necessarily what I want to be in. And I'm having this conversation. It's uncomfortable for me to have this conversation with y'all.
Right.
I'm letting y'all know, like, keep your hands down while you're talking right now. Like, it's one of them kind of conversations. Like, I fuck with y'all. But, and I fuck with y'all, like, on some little bro shit. Like, not, I'm trying to little bro you, but, like, you know what I'm saying? I care about y'all if something happened to y'all.
Mm-hmm.
But if this conversation keep going the way it's going, I'm going to be what happened to y'all. Like, just, for real. I was just like, calm down. I feel you. And when he say the alcohol, it was the alcohol, but I was telling him, like, hey, I know me. So just let's not shout about none of this shit. Like, because you could be saying help, but if it's at a certain octave, bro, I'm finna be on your ass. Like, yeah.
It's the way that you approach your the way you approaching me is like, I'm going to react on something.
Yeah, and it's just like, bro, like, I understand it. And I was telling him, bro, like, I understand how y'all feeling about y'all pranks. If we was down to the nitty gritty, if we was telling the truth about all the money that flowed through that situation, I was like, bro, like, I feel you. I feel you. I promise that $100 ain't coming to me. I promise it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just
what it is. It's
business. We all got to take our L's in this certain situation. What y'all did was kind of messed up, and y'all did like a little chess move, and you just realized that
that chess move wasn't what it was.
You might not be a pawn, but you finna lay down on the board.
You had to pay for that. And it's only real, and because that's how things in business go, man. I asked you to come up and perform and do something for me, and you came and show up a certain thing, and you slide. Hey, bro, I'm not finna give you.
I'm gonna say this. Hold on, Biz, before you go any farther. When you, like you said, when you seeing something grow, you know, people tend to feel like, I made this grow. I'm a part of this. I remember that episode. You know what I'm saying? I remember what was transpired and said. You know what I'm saying? Because what actually had got on the topic, how we got on the topic was because I was like, hey, y'all, you know, we just dropped that when I was doing the shirts. I said that, and then I guess that triggered it, you know. And I remember what was said in that aspect, but is everybody want to be a chief. Don't nobody want to be an Indian.
That's the thing about, you see what I'm saying? Before you become a CEO, man, you got to be a worker, man.
You have to. But you know, a lot of people are sitting there and judge on what they already seen that's their success. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? Like, he didn't. I don't think they took into account the work that Jess put in before she came to this. Before you know, the work he put in before they came to this. Everybody that didn't put in their little, you know what I'm saying, 2 cents to make this show even greater or bigger than what it was. You know, I think it was a young minded move. It was arrogance. It was cocky. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It was like,
it'd be like that.
This. We see the crowd rocking with us. This what it is. I just ain't feel
they
like
want to take charge of it, but really you can't. You're not in a position to take charge at the moment.
Nah, you're not, because you. I told him. I said, bro, you are. I know y'all don't want to think of yourself as this, but this is a machine. Smoking word is a machine. Right now, you niggas are a screw. If the screw loose, if the screw go away, it's not gonna work how we want it to.
Right.
Yes. But it's still gonna work. You just one screw.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, you're going to be what?
Yes.
You're gonna be replaced.
Yes.
And I said, dawg, I said, look at me. I am a screw. There are weeks that I'm not here. I'm in California. And guess what? The show goes on, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Like, people can come and tell me, oh yeah, you the vibe, you like, I don't wanna be there if you're not there. The show gonna go on
without you there or not.
If I'm there or not, like, it's gonna go on. It might not be the same show, but it's the show. And I told them that, and they was like, "Nah, nigga, we quit." And I was like, "Okay." So the next week, like, I think the next day, like, y'all was replaced by more. I'm not gonna say better, more seasoned and more known.
Exactly. Musicians. You got caught up in your feelings in a way.
And it went up. Like, them niggas know everything from shit, the Flintstones theme song to.
And that's the thing. You got to have an empty cup. You can't always go in there with a full cup.
Right.
No matter what you're doing. You could be the best of your talent, whatever, but still have an empty cup when you're going, because you always got space to learn something.
And like he said, like everybody want to be in, you know, Chiefs and not Indians. In this situation, I'm what you would consider the perfect Indian, because everybody else saying, "Oh no, Chief," and I'm like, "Nah," mm-hmm. because I know what Jess did before all this. Mm-hmm. I wasn't originally part of Smoking Word. Like I wasn't. I came on some drunk shit. She needed to either use the bathroom or handle some other business shit, and she just handed me the microphone. She didn't say do this on the microphone. She just handed me the microphone like, "Hey, I'll be right back." And it just happened.
And how your it happened. Talent just kicked in.
It just happened how
that's
it happened.
That's the artist, there, like, boy. I hear you, baby.
It just happened so, how it happened. But,
so what did you do when that happened? When she handed that microphone to you?
I think I was just doing a bunch of crowd work, like you know how comedians be doing shit. Like I was just doing some crowd work. Like I just got lucky and
yeah, this nigga funny too.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, because yeah, I be a little comedian
like,
too.
He's like a one man show.
That's
like,
what's up.
Listen, but the thing is, I probably could be. But had it not been for her, like I would have never realized none of that. So I don't think I ever want. Like I probably could do a show by myself, but I don't think I want to.
Why not?
Because it's you, like
it's fear about it.
Nah,
it's money
like,
though.
Most of the, it is, but it's like most of the shit that I do be reactive and not proactive.
See, I'm like that too. So, it's like it's just fall in place. Yeah. Okay,
so here's
I got
the thing.
You.
So same thing like we was talking about earlier when we was just riding to the store. I'm not saying like, oh no, just do like it's other days in the week.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like you can go do something else on Wednesdays at Jazzy's or you know what I'm saying? Like you or even once
you putting that brand in.
Even once people get into their careers, their seasons and stuff like that, you know how they get a residency in Vegas and shit, and they doing the comedy, they doing the singing, rap, whatever, improv. Yeah. Wayne Brady, you a Wayne Brady ass
it's,
nigga.
it's a new year.
But you have to do all that shit though.
Yeah, nah,
you got to be on every corner because that's how you gonna get it known.
Nah, listen, it's a new year.
Right.
All the opportunities that I kind of like, I'm not gonna say missed out on last year, but the ones I didn't necessarily take advantage of last year. My personality and just who I am as a person has afforded me the luxury of being able to spin the block. You know what I'm saying? Like here, right now. Like you book a nigga 10 times, you're not finna book that nigga no more. But this nigga hit me up today and I was like, okay, we finna do what we said we was gonna do, and we gonna follow through with everything that we said we was gonna follow through with. So this nigga asked me, I showed up early. You know what I'm saying? Not just on time, I showed up early.
That's a fact.
And so from this year, y'all finna see not a different bitch, but like a
you on your shit on every corner.
Pretty much, it's
if
it's
you
like,
say you doing it, you doing it.
Yeah, pretty much. I gave like a little taste of it at the end of the last year, like on some business shit, like you not finna play with me type shit. But just from now on, I gotta stand.
Hey, something you would like too that I want to incorporate. You'll like this year, right? I know you down to give us some bars, man. Like, just get on the beat. We want to get our own little segment. Listen, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, Biz, I know you ready to go in.
That's what he do. Like how Cho's came in here.
Yeah. Hey, Biz.
That's what the fuck he do.
Yeah, that's what's up.
That's what the fuck he do.
I can pull the pipe up now. We can drop something.
Pause. But
hey, we call the pipe. It's the phone. It's the phone. That's another word we call the phone. It's the pipe.
Oh,
this guy.
Yeah, you got there it is.
No, it ain't.
11 minutes.
Listen, wait. Which 11 I minutes. Is, I've been over here sipping the fuck out this Gatorade. Though.
Getting your electrolytes up.
Not finna get me today.
Because for some odd reason, we can't get no water.
Nigga been asked for water. Nigga been asked for water, man.
11 minutes, man. Let's go. I like this game.
I'm about to door dash some water, man.
I got half black.
I'm about to get a six-pack around this bitch, man. I got shit to do when I leave here.
This is great. I'm home.
Hold up, man.
End up with saying I'm home. That's why,
see, that's why he liked the game.
He's so full of shit.
Yeah, that's why he liked the game,
but
man.
But also, he hospitable, so it's like, okay, you can stay where you
are. Yeah, you good. Like, I got an extra room. It's okay.
The spot I left him in is the spot I left him in.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Man.
Look.
Y'all that was a little poor, easy, but I, you bit. Good. Don't blame
mind,
them.
Mind your business, dog.
I'm watching it.
Mind your business, dog.
I'm watching it. Let's go.
I feel
salute,
like
salute, family.
Salute, man. We ain't even got into no real shit yet, man. Let's do it.
Nah, we here. So, 11-11, man. Yo. Explain that to me, bro.
I like 11-13. Yeah, I'm on that.
I've been wrecking my brain over this for the past couple of years. You know what I'm saying?
When it came to numerology,
yep.
I wasn't really into it when I first. I've been posting 11-11 for like six years, and it had nothing to do with biz 11, none of that. It was just a number that I caught all the time before I even knew about numerology, before I even knew about anything, and then in the last maybe like 3 years, I started trying to get into numerology. 2 years ago, I was outside of a party. About 2 years ago, I'm outside of a party, and we drinking, and it's a nigga younger than me. He came up to me, he say, it's something about the number four. Every time I see you, I'm always seeing a bunch of fours and shit. And I was like, this nigga is drunk. And he was like, nah, man, like I keep seeing it. And so if you look at 11-11, put it together, it's number 40.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, man, what the fuck is this nigga talking about? He was like, bro, like he said, look at the spot you standing in. I'm looking at the spot that I'm standing in. This is where he stopped me. He can't. I was leaving the party. He stopped me, and he said, look at the spot you standing in. I'm looking, and I'm like, My shoes at the time was like lighting up a little bit because like I think the Nike Che had like some fluorescent shit on it, and I was like, damn, okay. And he like, yeah, look up. I look up. I'm directly under the light, right? And so he said, look around you. We look around. The address was, I think like 1111. The something else across the street, it was like a truck or something. It had like three folds on it. And he was like, bro, like every time I see you, literally, I see a bunch of fours. I see like, and he told me to look it up, like what my birth number was or some shit. And it ended up being four. And he said, the nigga, like I said, another nigga younger than me. He was like, bro, it's like it's four versions of you. And you walking around being those four people all the time. And it's like, I was like, okay. At that point, all I was thinking about was the singing and the rapping. Now I'm thinking about the singing, the rapping, the hosting, and now I'm thinking about my actual self.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like, he said, bro, like, once you master those four people and you like know how to fluidly become those four people in a moment, he was like, you're gonna be something to deal with. I had dropped the Grove. Like the Grove was what was like, okay, yeah, he making a little noise, like he do something. But then after that, he told me that I ain't really do no research or nothing, but like it was just, I'm still not a woke nigga. Like I just can't be because
we all are woke. We just not in tune yet.
No. I'm a nigga that recognizes, like.
I get it.
I say I'm a lucid dreamer.
I'm
not a woke nigga.
Hold,
I'm a lucid
hold
dreamer.
Hold on. Give me a second, Biz.
Yeah.
We'll be right back in the Gunshine State Podcast.
Yeah.
Lucid dreamer. Dude, and we back to, like you said, lucid dreamer. Let go.
All right, so I was saying I'm not necessarily what you would call a woke nigga. I'm more of a lucid dreamer. And when I say that, think about the Matrix. Neo was Neo,
mm-hmm,
when he was in the Matrix, right?
Neo the stand Matrix, for one, two, the leader.
Oh damn, 21. Yeah,
I'm on that.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, give, okay. Give all right. Oh, damn. Listen. Never mind. Oh, damn. You almost fucked me.
I know that's not the alarm. I swear I know that's not the alarm. I know that's not the alarm going off right now.
Every time we say 11 or say 21, God.
Hey, man. Let's take shots. Damn. We back. Happy New Year.
We came back on 11.
Fuck. Happy New Year. You know, one and one is two. You feel what I'm saying? And it's the second. You know what I'm saying? And one and one is the 11. You know? I'm just saying. Y'all ain't do the math.
All right. So this on the right. So at this place, man, we supposed to be right here.
Yeah, hey, man. Place we supposed to be at.
And I booked. And I booked him 10 times. He showed up on the 11th. Oh! Oh!
Hey, we taking that. Hey, so you know what? It goes right back to my
drop.
Bad homie.
This the drop. This the clip. That's the clip right there. That was the clip.
And we going back on your homie saying about your 11 and 4s.
Mm-hmm. So when I said I was like the Matrix, Neo was only Neo with the powers in the Matrix. So the Matrix was what we see as what sleeping people see as the regular world. Mm-hmm. He was a superhero not because he was outside of the regular world, but he was in it and knew it was fake, and he was a lucid dreamer. He was still in the sleeping realm, but he was cognitive of everything that's going on. So when you sleep and you dreaming, but you know you dreaming, you can do whatever you want to. But the thing was, like, why I say I'm not a woke nigga is because a lot of the, I feel like y'all gonna have a name or a picture of a person in y'all head as soon as I say this. But when it come to being a woke nigga, I fuck with them how I fuck with them, like from like arm's length, because a lot of them be on some real sleeping ass nigga shit, like. Oh. They be preaching all this woke shit, but really be on some like
one track mind. Is this picture was somebody local you was talking about?
No, yeah. But
Okay. I think I gotta
listen. So go ahead.
I watched the I gotta get into it. Like, I mean, nigga can't beat my ass. So I watched a nigga make a video recently, and the hashtag for the video was on some uplifting black women type shit, right? That's what the main thing of the video was. But when you are behind the lens can't capture nothing but what you focus on. Mm. So when you uplifting women in the hashtag, but the lens ain't nothing but objectifying the women that's in the video, like literally, like you, like I can tell who you want to talk to by who you spend the most time on in the video. Mm. So it just be that type of shit that niggas
dirty macking.
Like I can tell, you know, I'm like, damn, why this nigga so focused on this one female in the video? Like okay, if that's what your hashtag is, I'm not gonna say what it is because I don't personally have a beef with the nigga, but. Like I said, I don't personally have a beef with the nigga because the nigga ain't never did nothing to me. What I will say is the nigga has a reputation for being
what you standing on, what you trying to put out there.
He has a reputation for being not necessarily the most genuine nigga. Mm. I peeped that 5 years ago. But because I peeped it 5 years ago, I wasn't in a position to say nothing 5 years ago. I've been in a position, you know, for the last 2 years to say what I want to, and nigga can't do nothing about it. But it's just those type of niggas that, because I consider myself a genuine nigga. I'm always going to be me regardless of who around. Like, I have no choice. Like, If people see me as a nerdy nigga, a hood nigga, whatever, I'm literally being me at all times. Like, it's just...
It just depends what you see you at that moment.
It's just four of me.
Exactly.
Mm. Apparently. Exactly. Apparently, it's just four of me. And so...
I can relate to that.
Right. So, it's... Me not being a woke nigga is not on purpose, but it's also kind of on purpose. It's like, as much as I want to preach to everybody and be like, hey, man, we need to do this, 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 and this, I appreciated the time that I was asleep. Mm. I appreciated it. Like, when they say ignorance is bliss, the moment I opened one eye and was like, oh, the real world got me fucked up. Like,
yeah, but that's why I say you are a woke, but sometimes we all are woke because we walking around and we living. But it's just at times we not in tune to certain situations.
I'ma say what it is. Okay. I'm woke, but I woke up and realized there was a monster in the house. And the monster can't touch me as long as I pretend I'm asleep.
Mm. Well, elaborate.
So, you know when you're a little kid and you feel like you afraid of the dark and shit, what's the first thing you do?
I go under the cover
and I pretend like I'm asleep. Mm-hmm. But monster can't touch me as long as I'm asleep.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, no.
Go ahead.
But for me, because I'm from Miami, I was afraid of the scream killer. Uh-huh. And I knew that the scream killer couldn't get me because I had bars on my windows.
This nigga was...
He literally can't get to me. This nigga threatening me with a knife all day.
Well, go ahead.
But I feel like then you feel like you're scared of the dog and you the monster, whatever. You go under your cover, and you realize how to like attack him now.
Man, it's dark.
Thing is, that's when you realize, like, when you're afraid of the dark, you no longer afraid of the dark itself. You're afraid of.
The shit that was hiding in the dark.
Like, you okay? Like, yeah, the dark by itself is just darkness. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, you're gonna be afraid of it, but it's because you don't know what's surrounding you. But once you wake up, like, you even you got just an eye open. Now you aware of what's around.
Exactly. So now you got to stand. Now you stand up on and know what you got to do.
Listen, when I say I'm aware, I'm so aware of what's around me to the point where. I know when niggas playing with me or not.
You are woke.
I know. Like, I know when you being deceitful. I know when you being genuine. I know when you want something from me. But I also know how to maneuver within that. Like, I realize that everybody is on the chessboard. We playing different games. We all got different positions on different games in everybody's life. Like, between y'all two, y'all playing a game, may not realize it. It may not feel like y'all playing a game, but y'all playing a game. Between y'all two, y'all playing a game, but y'all playing a different game. Mm-hmm. You're not playing the game, you playing the person.
Yeah.
And so you got to move according to that person. And I'm not saying that because I'm just, I don't trust nobody. I trust everybody to be themselves. Like, I trust this nigga to be himself. Like,
yeah, I'm like that too.
This nigga has never showed me nobody but himself, like, off real.
So you're going to expect him to be himself.
I expect him to be himself. So when I say you playing different games with people, there are games that I am losing on purpose. There are games that I am losing on purpose because the person that I'm playing can't handle losing. They can't handle losing. And it's the fact that I know that I can beat you.
I totally agree with that. But I hear where you're coming from with that.
But I'm not gonna beat you because I love you.
Exactly. That's why I say I understand where you're coming from.
I don't take
in that. Listen. And you know what happened is when you do that, then the next person think they got the upper hand on you.
Right. But this is a different game.
And they show themselves the wrong way because they want to be all. They think they got the upper hand on you, and they do. And you're like, bro, you know what? And you stop fucking with them completely.
But that's a different game because the nigga. Just me knowing that you watching me play this game is a game in itself. Mm-hmm. Once I realize that you watching this game to see how I move so you can see how you can do me. All right, so boom. Soon as you make a move, even if it's going to cost me dearly in the end, further down the future, every time you make a wrong move, I'm going to beat your ass.
Exactly.
But I didn't do that with them because that's them. You not them. This game is way longer. I want you to know that even if you win at the end, you got your ass beat. Like, you can't play with me. Like, you can't play with me. Like, the plan that you had that you was finna set in motion, you was thinking three steps ahead. Oh, yeah, fuck that. You thought I was going to be smarter than that. I am smarter than that. But guess what? I'm choosing violence today. Okay. So what you finna do now? Oh, okay. What you finna do now? Mm-hmm. What you finna do after that? And I learned that in jail.
What'd you go to jail for?
Violation of probation.
What were you on probation for?
That's the right question.
So I went to jail for technically it says trespassing. What happened was I was not trespassing, but that's the only thing that they can make stick because you don't have to have no trial for that shit.
Right.
Niggas so, hit you real quick with that.
An inconvenience fee. That's what it was. He hit me with an inconvenience
fee. Court costs.
Yeah. So what happened was I'm outside of Moncrief Liquor Lounge. My cousin was DJing at the time, and he needed help breaking shit down. So it's like 1:30. The club done closed to 2:15. Actually, it's 1:15 at the time because we were still outside drinking.
Nope. We are not.
I changed it to 1:15.
Yes, we did.
That's a one and a one put together. Yeah. And then five.
I'm going to skip that shit there.
1:15. Right on time. Five.
So we stopped. So, 11 minutes.
My shot. This is what I'm
11 minutes. Let's go, man.
Nah, this your
motherfucker. What time is it?
Because I don't even fucking know, dog.
I'm trying to get off.
my business hours is from 3 to 5 to 6, nigga.
3 to 5.
Six, nigga.
Hey, I'm
the fuck wrong with you, nigga. You know what's going on.
The extra hour you got, that's when you go and wrap your shit up. But I'm going with 5.
No, the fuck is not. It's how we do it in here.
Oh, I know. Damn, I'm gonna let you fuck me up. All right, so I went to jail for We was outside Moncrief Liquor Lounge. Gotcha. And cause I'm gonna tell this story cause I see how it's gonna go. So I'm outside Moncrief Liquor Lounge. This nigga say, I'll let you slide.
I don't know y'all noticed, but my shot went from here to like right here.
I'll let you slide.
This bitch.
Cause I hey bro.
Yo, hey. Five, about to kill me,
Jesus paid it all, so yeah. I let you slide, bro.
Hey. Hey, listen. Nah, you hit him with that.
Nah, I did, bro. Hey, that ain't that boy crossed the bear right now. I can't even say the word. So, we outside Moncrief Liquor Lounge. The police tell us to move because cars are coming through the area we standing in. Because cars coming through because the business still open. So, I had a beer and a half because I got there late only because I'm only there to help my cousin break down because he's a DJ. Me and my homeboy standing up against the wall. Police say, hey, y'all need to move. Car's coming through. I turn to my homeboy. I say, hey, boy, yeah, let's move before we get our head hit by a car. Back then, I wasn't as vocal. I used to mumble when I talked like I was real low. Police officer say, what you said? And I said, oh, no, I just said what you said, but my way. And he was like, matter of fact, why you even over here? And I was like, oh, we helping my cousin. And when I said my cousin, this nigga grabbed my collar and was like, nah, you coming with me. What he didn't know was, one, I didn't wear jewelry up until 2016 because I had this thing with my neck. Like, if you touch around my neck, no matter who you is, I'm on your ass. Because
you feel like you're trying to
contain
me in
like
some type of way.
Yeah, it was like, uh-huh. No, really, like, it was real bad. Like, my godmama caught the worst of it. Like, I had my whole family about to fight me one day because she was like, nigga, you. And she went to grab this part of my shirt and she missed. And I slapped her hand and hopped up like, oh, I'm finna, shit. What's up? Like, but so that happened. The police officer, we tussling. But he like 5'7".
Give me this goddamn phone.
This nigga like 5'7". So I grab the top of his little bulletproof vest and I look at my homeboy like, hey, once I shake loose, we out of here. Like, we gone. I couldn't run to the right because ain't nothing but a field. If I run to the left, his partner out there. So I literally had to shake him without like alerting
and
his partner.
And push him forward.
And push him forward and then get up out of there. Go like, I had to run across the street. So I get loose. My homeboy looking at me. Like, he like, all right, I'm with you. Like, I'm with you. But when I get loose, his partner is behind me already. Big 6'4" Michael Clark Duncan looking ass nigga. Like,
damn.
That nigga grabbed my shoulder. He said, what we doing? And as he said, what we doing? He was taking me by my pants and my shoulder and slammed me on the ground.
I got one of those before.
Nigga. Remember the slam. Okay. Just remember the slam. So we fast forward. This is right before Mike Brown died. So we was on police brutality, but it wasn't really like video documented like how it is, like we where we in nigga shit, like they ain't got body cams and none of that shit. So this nigga take me in the back of the police car. He got me like this. I got cuffs on at this point. He got me. I'm choked out. I'm about to pass out. At this point, I hear people screaming, but the screaming like starting to fade. Like I'm passing out.
Mm-hmm.
And then he just let me go. And then I hear, but it's me. Like, I hear it. Like, I hear it from the next seat. Like, I'm, yeah.
Sound like you hearing somebody else doing that.
And I was gone. I was gone. But I heard it. Came back. And then my homeboy was recording the whole time. They took his phone, deleted the video, arrested him for trespassing.
And you know that's against the law, too.
Trespassing.
Oh, so they ain't get you up. They ain't give y'all a higher charge because they knew they was fucked up.
Listen,
that's against the law. Yeah.
Initially, my charges were trespassing, resisting without violence, and then assault on an officer.
That's something.
But when I got downtown and got in front of the judge, how you gonna give him resisting without violence and assault on an officer? So they was like, all right, we're going to knock them two charges off. We're going to give him trespassing. And my words were, how you going to give me trespassing if the business was still open?
And I was doing something for my cousin.
Listen, these niggas took me around the corner when they arrested me. Took me and my homeboy. We sitting in the car together. They arrested him because he had his phone out or some shit. Took us around the corner. And me and him having a fucking stand-up comedy show in the back in the back seat. Because we laughing at this point. So, oh, we'll be out in the morning. We didn't realize we was doing that for like 30 minutes. They didn't even start their paperwork until 2 o'clock. So the business closed.
So business now closed. That it's closed now, it shows
trespassing.
That.
I'm trespassing.
Oh, wow.
So I understand
they already,
that.
They already lined y'all niggas up.
Line me up. So we get to the jail. Remember, the slam. Me and him still continue our fucking Abbott and Costello act. We still making these niggas laugh. You know what I'm saying? Pantomiming for the fucking police and shit. We standing there like this. And I say, oh. The fuck? And I spit something out. This nigga said, damn, boy, you spit a tooth out? This nigga had to slam me so hard that a piece of gravel from the parking lot was lodged in my mouth. The whole time. And I thought it was so lodged in my gums that I thought it was one of my teeth. I didn't even know it didn't hurt or nothing. Spit that bit out. I go. We got first appearance in the morning. My homeboy called his old lady, buying him out in the morning. I said, well, you wasted your money, nigga. We was getting out in the morning anyway. This nigga get out. They give me 9 months probation. Trespassing.
Damn.
I violated in my first month because I had to go to work and I told my probation officer, I called her 3 times, left a message to say, hey, you're not picking up, but I'm only working a certain amount of hours. I can't afford to live my life and pay y'all this $60. It went number $60, but I can't afford to do that right now. I had a son on the way.
You got shit to do. Shit added up right now.
She checked the messages and violated me. So I spent two and a half years with a warrant out. Now I was working at AT&T. I accidentally set the alarm off at the company. The police pull up. He checked my ID. See, I got a warrant. Look at me like, I'm gonna give you a pass today. Like, I'm gonna give you a pass, bro. Cause my son was up there. Cause at this point he'd born. My son, mama was there.
Damn, he was picking me up from work. A bitch.
I'm at a store that I don't usually even work at, bro. I'm closing a store that I don't usually work at. So that's why the alarm went off, because I didn't know the code. Mm-hmm. So 6 months passed by. My brother in the hospital on his deathbed, for real, for real. And I'm supposed to go see him, bring him some food at the hospital. I procrastinate all day. I clean the fuck out my house. And you know, anybody that's really into the word and really, and hold on, I got to finish this part.
Hold
really,
on.
We
and we back with another episode. Hey, oh, I don't even know. Hey, Q, we good? We good?
We
good? Recording
on
we recording over there?
Yeah, little red light on.
Oh, that's
yeah.
good. Dude, that's great.
He gonna put all hey,
no,
into
no, 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 no. That's going into the documentary. That's going into the documentary. They gotta wait for that. They gotta wait for that.
Later this year. No, we came back from commercial break and I was like, damn, I thought we did that like 10 minutes ago.
Nah, who's seen the lighter? No. It's going into the documentary, right, man. Y'all niggas gotta be here, man. Hey, man, so at this point in time, as y'all know, we are a little twisted, you know what I'm saying? And it's great. I've enjoyed this time. I've missed this time with you guys. You know what I'm saying, Pauls?
I'm coming back, bro. That's what I got to.
Yeah,
I
exactly. We didn't even get into everything, bro. Right, like yeah, this did. Is the vibe,
see,
though. You know what I'm
we
saying?
We said the vibe. See,
this is a different type
trying
of thing.
To get you into, but it's okay. We understand you're a businessman. Yeah, you know what I mean?
This is back. A different type of thing. Back. You know what I'm saying? So this is a part of time where we get into the shoot the shits of our podcast, and we were sitting up here talking about like. So this is literally current event.
Somebody easy. Saying I snapped in that battle with Riz.
Oh, shit.
Hey, what's up with that, man?
I got to find that beat because what the main man that came here that snapped on the beat?
Who chose? Chose, yeah.
Yeah. I could, did you hear that?
Nah, I ain't hear it.
Oh.
I ain't have to.
You ain't have to?
We're going to get bars.
Oh, you ain't have to. So that's how you
feel? So we
ain't
going to get the bars. We just going to get the bars.
We're going to get a bar fest from Biz.
I almost forgot. Y'all niggas. I'm glad y'all doing your job.
All
right, so let's go. So matter of fact, let's go ahead. Let's hurry up and wrap this shit up so we can get to what we need to get to.
The Gunshine State
Bar Fest. All right, so easy, go ahead.
The Bar Fest.
Somebody said that already, but we come up some different shit. I got you. We'll figure it out.
All right, current events. This is the shit with AB.
Literally current.
Literally, this is like within the last couple hours. Antonio Brown of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Miami native, shouts out to AB.
He took off his,
nigga, man.
Yeah, he pulled the Miami nigga stunt.
Hey, man, watch your mouth.
Nah, he did, though. He did. That was the most Miami shit I ever seen in my life.
Hey, but real shit, this is how you know he was a Miami nigga. Nobody touched him on the way out.
What they gonna do?
Nobody touched AB on the way out. Hey, man, let him go.
And real shit, I feel like he told y'all before the game.
Because the way his
I feel like he did.
The way his posture is, and the way he was like, he took his shit off. And they say Michael Evans and the other wide receiver was like, hey, man, yo, chill out. Don't do this, man. Don't do this. So it was things like that made me feel like, hey, I told you.
I can see that. I can see that.
Hey, no, listen. He might not even really want to do the shit, but he said it earlier, so now he got
Now I got to stand on the shit.
Like, man, yo, if they try me, bro, I'm going to walk off this shit, bro.
Hey.
Try me.
That nigga came out the huddle. He told Brady, you don't throw the ball this way.
You seen him. They tried me.
You know what it is.
Now what?
I'm out my shirt, nigga.
So this nigga took off everything and just threw it in the ground.
He took off.
So what are the context we got we got behind it? Like, what? So what
some saying is because something with a COVID protocol, which like me, I personally
don't believe
that. He
just came back off of COVID protocol.
I think what it was is, like somebody else said, he just came off an ankle injury. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if y'all been following this with AB lately. They like the fans been like dog calling him like, hey bro, you know what I'm saying? You this, you that, you this and that and the third, you know. But when he did come back and play, it's like, shit, nigga, I'm producing and y'all like, what's
oh.
up?
Oh. All right, that boy Damon say that boy was old money. But you know when niggas had them little performance contracts? He said he was owed money if he completed certain things and they had him on the bench. And remember what I said was like the nigga probably was open and they ain't throw him the ball.
Yeah.
And that's part of my shit. Like
and that's Tom team at the end of the day.
Yeah, it is. No, it's definitely Tom team. No matter where that boy go, that's his team.
You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
Me personally, my outtake on it.
Tom Brady is the LeBron James.
I feel like
when you when you that far into the league, I mean, you know, we all know AB is where he at in his career. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I feel as if though, like when you getting paid that amount of money, you know, it's a way to handle things with a level of professionalism. Cause not only did you just
man, fuck that shit, bro.
I mean, once again, they go on Miami, nigga. Fuck, y'all hear that?
Hey, yo, bro.
Y'all hear that?
Do they
handle that's a Miami nigga?
Do they handle you with a level of professionalism?
No, cause it's a business. At the end of the day, like
do they handle you like a business? Nigga, you can get traded. You, you can get traded. You can get traded and cut as you still playing.
Right.
On the bench.
On the field. They ain't got on the field, bro. You can get traded.
Now listen, and then and jobs want you to give you want you to give them a 2 week notice before you quit.
Mm-hmm.
They ain't got to give you shit.
Okay. Now let's look at it as a you know, as me being a business owner, I'm gonna say it like this. He's still a Antonio Brown, you're a business yourself. You're still a brand yourself. So without the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, nigga, you're still Antonio Brown. What little pop league is going to want you to come in and teach kids throw off their shit?
Okay, they ain't got nothing to do with the talent.
It has everything.
But,
okay.
But if you good enough, the next niggas ain't going to play with you.
But what team can he go to after?
But that's what I'm saying. If you good enough,
I'm gonna win a championship. You gotta go to another
listen,
team.
If you good enough, you are gonna get another another opportunity gonna come. But that next opportunity, yes, them niggas ain't gonna play with you.
But I think this was that next opportunity for AB. He
I know it definitely was.
He doesn't. He's not. I mean, just looking at his stats and looking at different things around him and the shit that the surface around him. But you're not that same Antonio Brown from the Steelers that was highlight catching, burning receivers.
Guess
you're not him no more.
It's a different game now. Because I disagree.
I think he still is. It's just like you say, it's a different game.
But even if he not,
it's a different scheme, system, and everything.
He can walk off the field right now, and with that momentum of him taking his shit off and quitting in the middle of the game, he can start a podcast
and go get money.
He can start TikToking.
Go Twitch.
Go get money. You got a million eyes on you right now.
Twitch pays the bills.
But okay, now let's
Chad
say like
Joe Single say.
Let's say it like this. Let's say he didn't do this. Let's say he didn't rip all that shit off. You get the youth camps. You get all of these.
You still get that. You think niggas in Miami care? You think niggas in Miami give a fuck about
some Miami nigga?
I'm telling you, that's where he's going. He's going home. He gonna go back to the crib.
Name one Miami nigga that never did some shit.
I'm gonna say it like
what I'm saying.
The nigga Ricky Williams can set up a account right now. He ain't
okay. Let's okay. Fuck the money. Your legacy, bro. You quit. You'll forever be known as the quitter now.
Yeah, but you quit on Tom Brady. So what the backstory is, we need to know that.
Okay, yeah, I want to hear the backstory. Like Damon said, the man with old money and this isn't that and the third. So, okay, y'all not throwing the ball to me. Y'all not trying to help me.
And if
you
it's
know
some
what I'm
real
saying?
If
like,
it's some real ass shit, his legacy is even more now. If it's some
if
real
that's
shit,
real, then yeah, he's real, he, it's yeah. more. Yeah. But if it's like, nigga, you just did some whole shit to be doing some crybaby whole shit, then, bro, I can't respect that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's the way the nigga was like, yo, the nigga was like, you got to.
What's wrong with you, man?
Hey, it's the way the nigga walked off the field and was looking back like, yeah, I damn want you niggas to touch me. You seen the clip? Yeah. I'm like, yo, this is a true Miami nigga.
At this point, we just got to chalk it up to Florida.
I think you know he definitely gonna make Donkey of the Day or whatever the case. Charlemagne.
Hey man, Charlemagne. Hey, I vow. This year, 2022. Every time you give somebody from Florida Donkey of the Day, Charlemagne, I'm giving you one right back. You per se, but I can find somebody as equal as dumb in South Carolina that did the same dumb shit in Florida. I got you. Every time this year, dog, you're not doing that. And I love you. And I love you, dog. Y'all know I fuck with Charlamagne. But hey, you can't do that. Reverse donkey some shit.
Fuck
wrong with y'all niggas, man. Every time. So, Black, you was talking about Kodak, man.
Yeah, Kodak, man.
I hear that beat, man.
Oh, damn. I'm up here working.
Yeah. You working. I got you.
But, yeah, Kodak. Damn. You fucked me up for a second.
You cool. You should have been. Go ahead.
Yeah, but Kodak, What happened to that boy? Like,
so yesterday we had seen Kodak Black like Hat got arrested.
Got trespassing some shit. Like,
hey, shouts out to Gold Money, man. Gold Money podcast, Tippy Toe podcast down there in Hollywood, man. Tippy Toe, you feel what I'm saying? I fuck with Tippy Toe. He reported that Kodak Black got arrested for trespassing at the projects that he was at, that he was giving out
ACs
and everything like that, man. Like,
I'm gonna tell you what happened. And then my thing is, like, how come every time we turn around, we trying to do something good for, even though we don't own the projects, and you know y'all got a certain way that y'all doing something, and somebody come up in the hood and say, "Damn, I want to come back and get everybody Cadillacs." You finna say, "Why you will come fuck with me?"
It ain't just about that.
What do you mean?
That's your mic, biz.
Oh, if
you can bring it out.
All right, so for the police, this is not me in defense of the police at all. This is me just understanding man hours and paying people. And Miami police, they budget ain't the biggest. But if you got a nigga that's a high profile rapper or celebrity in general, and he got beef with another nigga in Florida, and you going live giving out shit, no matter how protected you feel like you is, that's going to be a lot of man hours for the police.
Okay.
If you still in some shit with, they beef ain't resolved for real. Kodak and
Jetboy.
Yeah, his shit ain't.
I don't think that's not really a beef.
It's
me personally.
I think it is.
I think it's something there. I don't feel like it's beef. I feel like it's just like that shit that, you know, it's old school shit that you do for the TV. The shit that you create something for, you can keep a story
you
going.
You got to store waters. Store waters to catch fish, man.
Exactly. So I feel like that's what it is. Honestly, because you know.
Because
you know Zoe's. You know, those love is deeper.
Coming
than,
from a Haitian nigga, go coming, ahead.
You know, that's how I feel, and you know, and we understand the business, and then it's like, go ahead, they fuck it, let's do it.
Zoe's love hard, and but who they end up fucking up the most?
Themselves.
Nah, they end up fucking up somebody that they used to love hard.
Yeah, because it depends.
I gotta make an example out of you, because no, ain't nobody else gonna play with me.
Yeah, exactly.
Anybody always gonna be close enough to play with me.
Play with me, exactly.
They say with the situation though, with Kodak, once again, he got arrested last night. I was reading, his lawyer said that the apartment company sunk when he did the giveaway. The apartment company sunk his record label a cease and desist order.
Oh, like don't
the
come back.
The apartment companies and the cops, not knowing no better, they took the cease and desist order as a trespassing. Those are two different things. You see what I'm saying? So hey, when they arrested Kodak, now Kodak is in the place to where he can turn around and hit them with a lawsuit. Because he also, right that Christmas, he took like 5-6 families and paid their bills up and shit for Christmas and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, again, once again, what Black said is once again, what Biz said is they have to control that. You see what I'm saying? Because something happened, and once again, it's going to fall back on the apartments. It's going to fall back on the
apartments. Because if nothing happened, and everything worked out pretty good, and everything played out, why you got to give me a trespassing thing on there like that?
Because say, everything that he did was good, but what if it wasn't genuine? Dog, say you in jail and you go to jail and you walk in on your first day and it's a bag of chips on your bed.
No, you're not supposed to take that.
You ain't taking that.
Yeah, you're not supposed to take that.
But let's say you do take it.
Okay.
And then that nigga come back and
you
say,
fucking.
No, not even just that. He say you owe me for that.
You my homie.
What
because
if
some dog, shit pop off you?
Kodak paid your bills. You ain't know how you was gonna do that. He come back and say, "Hey, I paid your bills. Let me." What if this nigga was trying to set up the Carter, like, in that shit? But they have to think like that. Maybe it was out of the goodness of his heart, but they have to think like that. They ain't got no choice but to think like that. Why you doing that, bro?
Like, five lit over this bitch.
But literally, we in a position as the
Gatorade ain't gonna sponsor us anyways. But go ahead.
Right. Nigga, we ain't even hitting never mind. We ain't even hitting the 40 fast enough. But
but I totally understand it. But it's like, I just look at it like,
they have
damn.
They have to look at it like that. They have to, because given the opportunity,
but
even,
damn.
Even the most mild-mannered nigga would probably hit a lit real quick.
Yeah, I understand that. But you know what? The other side, they been on some shit like that. But if it's not coming off like that, we ain't giving out no violence. We showing love. You know what I'm saying? You think that, oh, I don't know what you got behind it, but I'm showing it ain't nothing behind it. Why are you still trying to hit me with something?
Let me explain.
But then this. But then you turn around and drop a song not safe for you.
Okay, exactly. The same token.
But
that,
it's that. But the song is not for them. It's just.
But it's
the music
it's,
world.
But it's for somebody. And they gonna pick up context and they gonna feel like, oh, this nigga still got some shit going
but
on.
But really, it's not, because sometimes you living in the music world and you living in the regular world. And in the music world, you like, damn, okay, I can't go in this music world and be
but
like,
but to the consumer,
hey,
the music world
cool.
is the real world. To the consumer, we proved that with okay. Biggie and Pac, bro. Them okay. niggas was not beefing for real. Like, for real, for
See,
real.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
But that's what I'm saying. They wasn't beefing for real until the outside world felt like it was real. And now
they
don't move like it's real. So the police got to move like it's real. They got to. They got to.
Better side
like,
token.
We putting them in that position. They got to.
When you giving stuff away at the same token, like, I done seen niggas like
that Nino Brown.
We
that,
came from
American gangster type shit.
Yeah, we come from an era, like, once again, like, I knew when the social media is different now because it's cameras, you know, but right. we come from an era where sometimes dope us ride through the hood, you know what I'm saying? Big U-Haul start giving shit out, you know? We came from that era.
Definitely we did.
I was listening to Wallow and he said he was talking to a young nigga.
Shouts out to Wallow.
Shout out to Wallow. Again. Shout out them boys. Chauncey
Gillis. Kind of vert down at the bar down at this do shit like
hey,
that.
But he was saying like, the level of star that Kodak is, he could have easily like, you know, hey man, here go $20,000, go do it. You know what I'm saying? Go get it to them. They ain't got no what's coming from me. Yeah. Ooh, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Undercover shit.
Grab one of them, tell them to take a picture with me. Boom, boom. It's ways you could do shit, you know? Mm-hmm. But I listened to Wallow say, he said he was talking to a young nigga and the young nigga was going to court and the young nigga was about to tell on the nigga. He said, young nigga about to tell on the nigga and He telling the young nigga like, hey man, you know what you about to do, man? You about to change his life. You know what I'm saying? Chill the fuck out, you know? The young nigga respond to him and was like, hey, OG, we ain't reading from the same book y'all read from. You know what I'm saying? Mm. You know, we read from that book, no kids, no women, no nothing. You know what I'm saying? These young niggas, they not reading from that book. You see you what know, I'm saying?
The kids these days is not reading. Our books back in the days is not what they read them. They books is completely different now.
It's, and he basically what he mean why that what he was saying not even so much but he's saying like as far as street terminology mm-hmm. they not reading from like what we read from or the like the gang that was giving
exactly.
us like hey man
respect,
you don't do this you don't do
that
yeah,
whatever
this,
no it's completely different
and he was like that set some type of clarity though for real you know what I'm saying because at like he said at any given time like though he made a song about it, this song is the number one song in the country right now. It's a threat.
It's a threat. Mm.
And it's more so coming from yet, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, listen to what the man said, listen, dog. Like,
even if it ain't no beef, if people think it's beef,
and they
think this nigga made a song about you, and it's the number one song.
You know, I'm screaming song.
Imagine how niggas
but you know that them niggas that take in like that I mean they was like had that more to do something to you like that.
But that's
niggas
why
gonna make
that's
a
why
song.
This beef is dangerous because both of them niggas saying it ain't beef.
And that
remember Yo Gotti and Dolph, both of them niggas was saying it wasn't no beef. Mm-hmm. Like they'll address each other, but like when interviewers come up, I'm like, oh no, like it's lightweight.
Yeah, but
at the end
behind
of the day,
the scenes,
in the
behind
day,
the
shit
curtains,
moving,
a whole
shit,
law.
Shit moving. Mm-hmm. So when I tell you a nigga that got beef with me, don't got beef with me.
Mm. Like he got beef with me.
He got beef by himself. Mm-hmm. He got beef by himself.
That beef so old it got mold on it,
nigga. The niggas that fuck with me let me know on the daily, like, you know what I'm saying, like you good, like you straight.
Yak a smart nigga too, yo. Mm-hmm. Yak is like if you really watch Yak, a lot of his moves be strategic.
Sometimes,
like, but sometimes he get caught with like just the camera rolling and
yeah,
you know,
but
shit
like
happen, you know. But
That's the bad part about
back
it.
Back to this, like I said, bro, this is number one screaming song in the country, bro. You said some direct lines to where it's like, hey, man, you know, nigga, I see you, I'm slapping shit out your tight shit. You know what I'm saying? Is that not? Like I said, and once again, Yak, Young Boy, all them Jack Boy, they all come from that era of shit.
It's certain shit. It's no lines. You can't pull back from. It's certain shit you can't. Like once you say something to a nigga, or once you bring his old lady into it, or once you bring like most of the times for younger niggas, once you bring a bitch into it, yeah, like they really fuck with. Like it's
And you know what? You absolutely right. But you know, by us being in day, and I know how that down south move. And me being a Zoe, and when you come up in a certain area and the things you gotta do to come up, it's like we'll play that part.
Yeah,
you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hey, let's go to the root of the problem, though, bro. The root of the whole fucking problem. Do you feel like Yak is wrong for feeling how he feel towards Jack Boy?
Honestly, neither one of them wrong. Neither one of them wrong.
Yes.
Neither one of them wrong.
I kind of agree with that a little bit.
The nigga Jack Boy was like, I felt like you just didn't support me how I was supporting you, how I was rocking with you. When you got locked away, after you came out, that same energy wasn't enough.
Yeah, I felt like when I came out, you said that you had some money for me.
I'm on your tail. I'm on your tail.
And Yak said, when I came out, you were supposed to have some money for me. Like, the niggas that I fuck with, for real, when they say shit like that, they
drop that.
They at the gates with it.
You came and told me all that, and then when I came to see what's up, he didn't even come to see what's up.
No, he didn't, because you was up there exposing this.
I'm doing this. I'm gonna do that.
You finna bring it to me.
And then when it come down to it, where you at?
Thing is, it's a lot of miscommunication in that situation.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
If a nigga say, I'm 10 toes for you. That nigga said that. His brother might not feel the same way.
Mm-hmm.
His brother might not even agree with the fact that you signed the nigga. Mm-hmm. So when I brought you, before I left, and I went away and I brought you into my camp, I showed you my hood, them niggas embraced you like you was family. Everybody might not have agreed with that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, bro, like, you when I get out, them same people that didn't agree with that, they saw how you moved based off of what you thought, and they was in my ear. Like I ain't got no choice but to listen. Them people, they been around my whole life. They seen what's going on outside. I see bits and pieces of it, and the bits and pieces, I'm saying, like lining up with what they saying. So just streetwise, like niggas, it's a lot of shit that done happened just here off of some hearsay and just miscommunication,
yeah,
and people
too.
thinking one thing and it's not the other.
Yeah, that's why I say you can't really just doge into like what's really on the surface and what is going on, because end of the day it'd be something else.
Yeah,
and then they know the business, and once you know the business, you know how to move the crowd. End of the day, it's all about get y'all talking about it. I need y'all to talk about this, and I need y'all to talk about that.
The difference is them niggas trying to straddle the fence.
Mm.
And if we was just business, then we could cut niggas' throats without them dying. but because it's not just business, and it's a street element to it, and you gotta protect your reputation, because in the streets, niggas only not touched because of what people say about them. Your reputation is what keep you safe for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
Cause every nigga done got caught slipping. It's a nigga that I'm cool with right now that I did not like. He didn't even know I ain't like him. It's a nigga that I'm cool with right now that I saw him walking through Orange Park Mall, and I tweeted. I said, damn, niggas really be slipping for real. I was at work and was ready to risk it all. Like I beat this nigga ass right now.
Exactly.
But, and it's like, I didn't do it because I realized, I was like, the issue I got with this nigga is superficial. Like, it's fuck. Like, this nigga don't even know I'm on the radar right now. Like, you know what I'm saying? This the fuck. Why the fuck am I even this mad with this nigga? But other niggas don't have that same mentality. Them niggas gonna move off of, that nigga said something about me. Even if it's not true, other people talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
I can't dodge what other people talking about. I can't outlive what other niggas talking about. So, let's get them talking about the fact that this nigga can't talk no more. So this is, once you mix, anytime you mix the street element with anything, street element got to live. The business gonna suffer.
Sorry.
This nigga, my bad, bro. The business gonna suffer. Mm-hmm. Anytime you mix the streets with the business gonna suffer because the streets got longer legs, bro. The streets got longer legs. That shit fuck with your ego more. Mm-hmm. If you built the business from the ground up, you can always say, oh, I can build that shit from the ground up. It's harder to build your reputation from the ground up. Mm-hmm. You can be that nigga, but as soon as a no-name nigga come up and slap you and you don't do nothing about it, you're not that nigga no more. Mm. You're not that nigga no more.
You ain't that nigga.
You're not that nigga no
slap
more.
You does.
Oh. You're not him.
The reason,
drop like this.
The reason I have been able to maintain being just biz for so long is because not just that, but anytime a nigga that felt like he can walk up and slap me, all right, cool. Hey, come talk to me real quick. Like, hey, come on, let's talk. The way I'ma talk to you by ourselves ain't finna be, you know, it's not for no audience. And I'm letting you know, don't do that shit no more. Don't do that shit no more. I fuck with you, but the niggas around you, the way they was clenching their teeth, looking at you, feel like you was talking to me a certain way, don't do that no more. I fuck with you because you was bold enough to do that. But them niggas don't fucking know you. Them niggas don't know you. 305 don't know you. Easy don't know you. Black don't know you. Strife don't know you. Strife don't know you. Like, that's enough said. Strife don't know you. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Dang, that's crazy.
And I know you, and I know you not who you just portrayed yourself to be. Look around. We by ourselves. Don't do that no more. Like, you was willing to talk to me like that in front of people. That's like, crazy. Bro, like, we by ourselves right now. You was comfortable enough to walk with me because this is who I've given you all these years. You gonna be comfortable enough to walk outside with me and talk to me like a man. But if I wasn't on no talking shit, don't do that no more.
That's crazy. Hey, so Biz, right? You like Pac in your collection? Like, what Pac song that you like?
All right. So I'm a fan of Pac only on two levels.
Okay. I'm a big fan of Pac, so that's why I wanted to know, are you in Pac?
I get around and How Do You Want It is my level for Pac mainstream wise.
So, let me ask you a quick question. So you know Pac got two records.
Well, listen. Okay. That's one level. How Do You Want It and I Get Around. That's my one level for Pac. Okay. My other level for is Hit 'Em Up.
Hit 'Em Up. Do you think what is Against All Means?
Against All Odds.
Against All Odds. It's better than Hit 'Em Up?
Nah. Hit 'Em Up is, for me, is more my style of like addressing niggas.
Hit 'Em Up was my shit too, because Hit 'Em Up was at a time that my mom was dealing with something with a dude, and he was like
It was my uncle?
No. Oh. But he was after your uncle. And family, you don't know. It was like my mom went through like a little crazy fight type shit or whatever, yeah, like that. And when I got into Pac, Hit 'Em Up was the main thing. And every time he came in, Pac was on.
I'm on your ass.
Yeah, I'm on your ass, like, nigga. I'm ready to fight all day.
And the clip you claim, nigga.
And I don't know your bitches and none of that. Listen, but you know what?
Ice Cube is a legend. Ice Cube got two levels with me. He mm-hmm. got Today Was a Good Day, mm-hmm. and he got No Vaseline. That's my mentality for most niggas, like, and I feel like that's me. Like, I'm either on some real melodic, like we singing, we okay, having a good ass time, or if it's that, it's that. Like, I'm
like, so do you go back on Pac songs and Biggie songs and kind of like get a little swag from them, and then go with your music? Could you go back on some old school shit?
If anything, it's gonna be Biggie.
Okay.
Biggie was
Oh wow.
No, okay. I'm saying as far as like with my music.
Okay, to get it like say like you like at a space that you block and you looking for a song, you want to come up with something.
He was painting a lot of pictures. Like Pac was too, but the pictures that he was painting was not ones that I wanted to like put out. Like his was okay. Like Brenda Got a Baby, the very pictorial shit that he was doing, it was way too deep. Oh, you get We gotta wrap it up.
We gotta get to these bars and shit. I wanna make sure everybody everybody like, right.
I was getting into my vibe now.
I see you wanna get into your podcast shit. 3 hours into the podcast. Hey,
you know, sometimes they take a while to kick in.
Nah, but you was on that shit last night. What are you talking about? So, hey, Biz, tell them where they can reach you at, homie.
They can reach me at Facebook. I'm going to give out my Facebook, even though it's my actual name, Brandon X Evans. And Instagram is BizKiat, BizQuiat. It's Basquiat, but Biz. And then, you can catch me on iTunes, Apple Music, anywhere you can download music. Biz Levin, BizLevin. That's it.
What you got coming up? You got something coming up?
Yeah. Right before Valentine's Day, we got the next project. This will be the first time I even released the name of it. But it's called The Arrangement.
Okay.
Y'all heard it here first.
Right before Valentine's Day, it's called The Arrangement. So y'all be on the lookout for that.
That's what's up. Okay. Easy. What you got coming up?
It's a new year. New shit for Apply Pressure, man. We doing some bigger shit than we did last year. Once again, you know we got more drops coming. Merch available right now. Y'all know you can find me at Easy to Plug on Facebook. Easy Does It For on IG.
Go hard. We finna go just fucking hard on you. We this, man.
This shit, man.
We can't fucking wait.
You see these dogs in your front yard?
Yeah, we doing that shit. A lot of more work, a lot of more consistency, man. That's what we doing, man.
Hey, black ass nigga.
What happened, Pippa?
You got coming
man,
up?
Man, shit, man. I'm out here aiming for that $1 million goal, man. Yeah,
fuck
man.
$1 million, nigga. We need 20.
Ooh, oh, fuck it. I'm on that too, Pippa.
We need 100.
Shit. $1 million ain't shit.
When I say the million, I'm just sitting at the spot.
You need to be scared right now. Ross said if you got 10 million, you need to be scared right now.
You're also, damn right.
In one of those same interviews, the nigga said, man, if you know how much money you got in your bank account, you ain't got no money.
Straight up. I like that. You're still counting your shit, nigga. Any day of the win, Elon Musk
and Jeff Bezos go.
You still can't afford something.
Them niggas don't
ask for permission to go out of space.
Yeah.
So and it's not illegal to go out of space like that if you got the bread and you got your shit.
Because niggas ain't have the money to do that shit. We not putting laws.
Bro, if you look it up.
With that kind of money.
Bro, if we got a rocket right now and we got the money, we go out of space, we don't got to ask nobody for it. It's not illegal.
So what you got coming up? You going to space?
Yes, nigga.
Let's do it.
Next week.
Elon Black, nigga.
Come on, yeah.
Hey, my dog Breeze just gave me that name. Yeah. Dog Breeze. Real shit, but nah, man. I'm just chilling, bro.
That's good.
Yeah.
I fuck with you, bro.
Yeah, man. I'm on it, my nigga.
Fine, what you got coming, G?
You already know, man. Four sportsmen in the building tomorrow. Man, we got Petty Lives Matter for the crank up in a couple weeks. No Name Podcast, Shits and Giggles still working, you know what I'm saying? We got a big interview next week. Mm. We're going to talk about that now, make sure we got everything straight. We got a big interview next week. I like to talk when the work done, you know what I'm saying? We're going to keep working. Oh, 5 interview goals this year. Iceberg, Young Cash,
let go.
T-Pain, T-Rone.
Said T-Pain?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what's up.
T-Pain.
And Trick Daddy. We're going to knock all those out this year.
Listen, two of them going to get knocked out at one time.
Hey, we stand on that. We take that.
We can do that.
We taking that.
We can do that.
Cash and Pain going to be at the same time. Mm-hmm. But y'all gonna be in Atlanta, though. They're not coming here.
Oh, we take that.
We ride.
Bro,
we
on the road.
We all day.
So, hey, man, Gunshine State Podcast.
Because we're going to let more dogs.
Hey, we got to get these motherfucking bars. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all tune in, man. Hey, man. So go subscribe everywhere, man. I appreciate y'all, man. Happy New Year. Gunshine State Podcast Network.
So you finna rap with me, right? Hey.
Let's go.
Okay. Who they say this shit for? You say Glock 9. The top 10 without me, just the top 9. They say life is a bitch, but the top fine. Huh?
It's wet out here, I'ma mop mine. Said we cleaning up. Yeah, we got a couple things that we was dreaming up. My dream is big as fuck, yeah. Big head nigga couldn't even imagine. But me, I'm a 88 dragon. I'm still breathing fire. Still on the scene though. Still mopping shit up. Yeah, still Mr. Clean though. Yeah, yeah, still Mr. Clean though. I ain't trying to be meek, but I'm a dream though. And then I'm gonna chase that. Oh, that's a bag, well, then I'm finna chase that. And that's a fact, man. I'm in the maze, but I'm no rat, man. But still hanging with the rat pack. Them niggas after the cheese, they after everything they wanted, they after the green. Well, me, I was after degrees. I went to school until the world got cold after degrees. I was still chilling, I was still heating things up. They still calling my name and bringing game up. Yeah, you calling my name and bringing game up. Well, it's cause I'm pimping and you lame, fuck. I make you take a stroll, I make you take a stroll. I played a whole part in the movie, made you take a role. Then you took a role, and then you took the scroll. And you tried to take the magic, and then you took the foe. But that was just for the sheep shit. I told you I'm a lucid dreamer, this a dream, bitch. And yeah, you sleeping, why you sleep, bitch? I make you toss and turn your sleep switch. I'm a nightmare on Elm Street, I mean. I know they felt me. They said they tried to Michael Phelps me. Was in the lap and I was swimming. They were screaming, help me. Bitch, I'm a shark. Bitch, I'm a demon. Bitch, I am hungry. The victims all screaming. Gunshots, what you mean? Feel like I'm a star and everybody's gleaming.
I'ma set the vibe around this bitch.
Yeah. Oh man, what we got next?
Snap on it, pimpin'. Turn up the boy mic. Turn up the boy earphones up.
Yeah. Hey. So they was looking for a bar fest. They called biz, that ain't far fetched. Tell my dogs to go and go and fetch. And then they bring me back heads. Okay, heads and tails, yeah, we coined the phrase. And now the coin is based. They talking about the Bitcoin and the crypto. I'm with them fives now, but I was with cryptos. We kicked those. We used to have to get the money. We used to have to sell the dummies. Out the house with the whitest bunnies. And now the forecast is sunny and we chillin' now. Got my soles in the tan and we chillin' now. Got my toes on the sand and we chillin' now. I have my fingers on the tan but I'm chillin' now. I'm in the villain, I'm a villain now. Everybody says that he is such a bad guy, but I'm way too deep, I guess I'm bag fries. I was with the birds and the magpies. Till the rooster start crowing. Until the crows start showing that they was really ravens. I was really amazing, I was really blazing. But they called me Levin. They called me 21 now. 21 now. I used to run with the nose. The nose is running now. Said I'm way too sick. Oh, come on.
Hit that boy.
Let's go. We just chilling. Got biz Levin in the motherfucking building. Gunshine State Let's Podcast. We on this bitch chilling, you know what I'm saying?
Let's
gonna get
go.
To it right now.
Take off. Huh?
Let's go.
Huh? Yeah. Put that boy in the box.
Let's go.
Put that boy in the box.
Had a bitch named Keisha, she slipped me a number. I called her. She ain't even called back. Said, I don't really give a fuck. I got plenty pussy, so I'ma fall back. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call that? Niggas talking noise, but you can stall that. Yeah, main friend in the house, Mr. Carl's back. Okay, now they talking Carl Jr., that's a little beef. Goddamn, biz Levin, he a little street. Yeah, he used to walk around with a little heat. But now I'm in the game with my little cleats. Said I'm still dancing, said I'm still on them. Feeling like I'm prime time, who is my opponent? Yeah, I'm back in 9-9, I was prime time. Yeah, you ain't catch that, but that line's fine. Goddamn, had to wind down. Said I had to take a little moment just to chill. Said I feel like that bitch in the yellow suit looking for Bill. I guess it's my time to kill. Said I'm on the line. Yeah, I'm on the line. Ready to cross shit. Ready to cross shit. Nah, nigga, I'm on the line. Yeah, I'm on the line. Talking some boss shit. I'm ready to off shit. Go. Ready to take a neck. Ready to take a necklace. Goddamn, I was way too young. Living reckless. Trying to catch me a little wreck shit. Damn, I'm feeling like a pirate trying to wreck ship. All niggas talking about the gold. They talking about the gold. Talking about the line, man. I'm talking about the fold, man. I'm talking about the new. And I'm talking about the old. Niggas talking about the weather, man. I'm talking about the cold. Said I'm freezing. Hard cold. Still freezing. Niggas be hanging out with niggas. It's called breezy. But still, me, I ain't nothing like easy. Cause he be trying to apply pressure. Me, I just be trying to chill. I be trying to chill.
Hey, man. Good time to say.
As soon as I said, I ain't nothing like easy, he was like, what the fuck you saying?
Wait a minute.
I see you, nigga.
Okay.